Hello and welcome to episode 50 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include a bittersweet announcement, a couple of studio sessions, and another trip to India. On the 19th of February 1961, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Casbah Coffee Club in Liverpool. As you will recall, the venue was in the cellar of Pete's house. In 1962, the Beatles, still with Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. 1963, the Beatles played an evening gig at the Cavern Club for the first time in a fortnight, sharing the bill with Freddie Starr and the Midnighters and Lee Curtis and the All Stars, featuring Pete Best, who by now was their ex-drummer. By this time, the lads were in such high demand that the queue for the admission to the club formed 2 days before the concert. Just before the Beatles started their performance, DJ Bob Wooler announced to the public in attendance that New Musical Express, one of the main music papers in UK, had sanctioned that the band's new single, Please Please Me, had reached the number one spot in the sales chart. The audience reacted with utter silence, evidently knowing that national success would take their beloved band away from them. Anyhow, the night would mark the last time the Beatles met Pete Best in person. After their performance, the lads were driven south to London in preparation for the Parade of the Pops broadcast of the next day. Just like the audience feared, the Beatles ended up playing less and less in Liverpool. Their Cavern performances became rare events. The soon-to-be Fabs had graced the Cavern stage only 6 times in January 1963 and 3 times in February. A drastic change if you think that in 1962, the Cavern felt like a second home to the band. Let's take a break with a quick reminder. If you like this podcast, please visit www.simonmas.com/support to see how you can help me increasing the quality of these shows. If you don't feel like making any donation, you can still show your support by sharing the podcast with your friends or leaving me a comment. Be fab and share the love. On the 19th of February 1965, the Beatles recorded You're Gonna Lose That Girl at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road between 3:30 and 6:20 p.m. completing 2 basic tracks and the necessary overdubs. Due to a mistake in the announcement of the takes in the control room, the basic tracks were recorded as take 2, a false start, and 3, respectively. No take 1 of the song ever existed. At the end of the session, the song had John's rhythm guitar, Paul's bass, and Ringo's drums on track 1, an electric piano part by an unknown player and George's lead guitar on track 2, John's, Paul's and George's backing vocals on track 3, and John's double-tracked lead vocals on track 4. On this day in 1968, Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr followed George Harrison and John Lennon to India to study transcendental meditation with Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. According to Ringo Starr, during the 20-hour flight, he and Paul decided to, quote-unquote, go the whole way and become vegetarians. They were accompanied by Jane Asher and Maureen Starr. Finally, in 1970, another 2 sessions went down at the EMI Studios focusing on Ringo Starr. Between 2:30 and 5 p.m., 8 singers, 2 flutes, an organ and a vibraphone were overdubbed onto Love is a Many Splendid Thing for Ringo's Sentimental Journey, his first solo work. Then, between 5 p.m. and 1:30 a.m., Ringo continued his recording of You Gotta Pay Your Dues, as It Don't Come Easy was still titled. He first overdubbed another vocal on the previous night's work, and then, after a hour-long break, he decided for a remake of the song. This took place between 7 and 11 p.m. with 10 new rhythm track takes. Some bass overdubs were added on take 30 before the end of the session. These recordings mark the end of this episode of What a Fab Day. See you tomorrow for more facts about the life of the Beatles. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.